Thank you, Stephanie, for your words and mostly for your leadership. I know how challenging the past few years has been for so many people, and the way you've stepped up and gathered stories and shared them and been at the center of so many important conversations about the work that needs to be done on reconciliation. I'm deeply grateful for everything you have done. I want to thank Elder Kamanda for your welcome onto this beautiful territory on this beautiful but very warm day. I want to thank the drummers, McWitch. Thank you for starting us off in the right way. Chief Dylan Lowite Duck, thank you for your traditional welcome. And especially to our elders, Eugene, Lavinia, Jimmy, thank you for your words. I know many people will remember your words long after mine have drifted away, as it should be. The stories, the knowledge, the truths you speak are unbelievably important, and I'm deeply grateful that you are part of it to remind us of all the work we need to continue to do. Aux survivants ici aujourd'hui, aux membres de leur famille, et à tous ceux qui sont ici parmi nous, merci d'être des nôtres. Thank you also to all the Indigenous leadership that is here today. I'd be remiss not to mention Cassidy Caron, the national leader of the Métis Nation. Thank you all for being part of this here. Je veux aussi saluer, bien sûr, les ministres Vandal, Miller, le ministre Fortier qui est ici, mais aussi des parlementaires, des sénateurs, des membres du Parlement. Tous sont ici pour témoigner de l'importance de cette journée. I can tell you our cabinet room is overlooking this flag, so we will be able to, as we deliberate on the important path forward of this country, be reminded that every child matters, and the work that we need to do needs to stay front and center. This flag is going to be a very important thing on this parliamentary precinct. Avant de commencer, je veux bien sûr souligner qu'on est sur le territoire traditionnel de la nation algonquine Anishinaabe, qu'on reconnaît comme les gardiens passés, présents et futurs de ces terres. On est réunis aujourd'hui ici pour hisser le drapeau des survivants sur la colline du Parlement, ensemble. This flag is an expression of remembrance. It is meant to honor all survivors and all the lives through the generations that have been, are being, and will continue to be impacted by the residential school system. It is an important but humbling moment to be here with you all today as a person charged by Canadians to serve this country through this challenging time on so many levels. And I am touched once again by the depth of the responsibility that I hold to serve you all well on this path to reconciliation and the work that needs to be done. Residential schools are a shameful part of our history. That is the truth. That's the truth we must continue to confront, to share, and to be open about. And that's the truth this survivor's flag is going to remind us of every day here on Parliament Hill. Residential schools tried to erase the identity of Indigenous children, your children. Avec le drapeau, aujourd'hui, ce qu'on dit, c'est qu'on va toujours se souvenir. On va continuer d'écouter les survivants. It says that we acknowledge the intergenerational trauma these so-called schools have caused, and that we commit to continue working together towards a future of healing and partnership. Le drapeau des survivants nous rappelle aussi que la réconciliation, c'est la responsabilité non pas seulement des Autochtones ou du gouvernement, mais aussi de tous les Canadiens. C'est notre devoir à tous d'être là les uns pour les autres, d'écouter et d'apprendre. And as such, on this flag that we will be shortly raising, you will see various elements that all Canadians can learn from every time they look at it. On the flag, above the children in the center, there's a cedar branch. Well, as Barney, a Nuchanuth survivor, told us, cedar is used in ceremonies for healing and protection. The cedar depicted in the image has seven branches representing the seven sacred teachings held by many Indigenous cultures, including love, wisdom, and respect. On peut aussi voir une plume d'aigle sur le drapeau. Et comme Phyllis, une survivante Mi'kmaq, l'explique, que dans sa culture, l'aigle a la responsabilité de transporter les prières du monde physique au monde spirituel. Quand une personne tient une plume d'aigle, le Créateur prête attention. And of course, at the center of the flag, you can see the children and the families. It's important that we remember those families who were ripped apart. With the identification of unmarked burial sites across the country, the pain has resurfaced for so many. We are here for you. Survivors and their descendants will continue to guide us now and into the future we build together. Last month, when His Holiness Pope Francis visited Canada, I sat with survivors to hear his personal apology. I felt their reactions. I saw the impact that it had. As we all know, healing is a long journey, and it's different for everyone. But we must all be part of that. And that's why I'm so pleased to be here today with all of you, with survivors, with leaders, with folks from government busy working hard on this. But I'm also so pleased that so many folks who swang by Parliament Hill today, perhaps enjoying the last bit of your summer vacation, visiting Ottawa, showing Parliament, your Parliament, to your kids, are able to participate in the ceremony. Because reconciliation is not just about Indigenous Canadians and government, while Canadians encourage and watch from a distance. Reconciliation is about each and every one of us who live on this land, who are accountable to the generations that came before and responsible for the generations still to come. We know that that residential schools spent decades teaching Indigenous children that they had no value, that their language had no value, that their culture had no value. And that had a terrible impact on them and on our country. But at the same time, in every single school across the country, non-Indigenous kids, all of us, were learning the same thing. That Indigenous cultures, that Indigenous languages, that Indigenous identity was less, had less value than what settlers have built. And that trauma, those teachings, those echoes live with us today still in ways that need to be reconciled, that need to be faced with truth. As we see a rise in discrimination and intolerance towards so many, the teachings that held Indigenous people to be somewhat less and not, in fact, more as they should be in this land, still echo. And it's each of our responsibilities as parents, as community members, as Canadians, to be part of reconciliation every single day. On a encore, bien sûr, beaucoup de travail à faire. Et le fait d'être ici aujourd'hui témoigne de notre volonté de poursuivre ce parcours ensemble en tant que vrais partenaires. On est là pour vous soutenir, pour être à vos côtés et pour vous encourager. Et on va toujours se souvenir et honorer la mémoire de ceux qui ne sont jamais rentrés chez eux. C'est ce drapeau qui va nous le rappeler à tous les jours. Merci d'être ici des nôtres, Miigwech, Kinanaskamotenaw, Masicho, Gaila Kasna, Nakumek. Thank you. Merci.